What's up, guys? So, another Cyberpunk video, and today I'm testing out a theory. I re-rolled the Netrunner I was playing. If you watched my last video, like, I was doing a Netrunner, and I realized that guns and brawling or fist damage is still really high. Like, it scales, or I don't know if it scales, but it was strong by default without putting any points into body. And basically, I decided to reroll my character and test a theory I have, which is the base level, all of this is OP by default. And like, the basically what it means is the game lacks balance, like, completely. So normally, if you create a character and you're progressing through an RPG, you would have to level your character. Does, like, it's nice to have many options. Like, you can do a gunner, you can do a netrunner, you could do a brawler, or you could use melee weapons, or even upgrade all your gear. Like, you could be a gear focused build, right? But or a stealth build, but usually you'd have to branch into one of them to progress through a game, especially on very hard difficulty. So my theory is that they haven't balanced the game at all, and we start out at a level that is already strong enough to handle all content without perks. And that's what I gathered from my level 10 Netrunner with 3 body, being able to take on Kabuki fights. It's like all the content scales with your level, but the base stats are OP enough that as long as you have some average gear and you don't, like, wear the starter gear, like, so as you defeat enemies, pick up gear. That's basically all the depth I can see to the character, to the building process, instead of having to level up and go into a branch to actually tackle the difficulty of the game as you progress through it. It seems to be that they've just made it that, like, naturally anyone that plays the game is going to go into one of the trees and start leveling it and picking up perks, right? And yes, that's normal. But usually you'd expect that you need to do that to progress through the game, and it just seems like, yeah, the lack of balance is, it's kind of hidden behind all these options. It's like these are just an illusion of, oh, I need to get these to be a strong brawler, or I need to get this to be strong with weapons, and it just gives this illusion of having choice and builds, kind of like how the main storyline has lots of dialogue options that lead to the same outcome. It's like they've just put this here, it's superficial, because you don't need stunning or any of this stuff to actually apply stuns. So I'm testing that theory out now. Basically, I've restarted the game. I've just finished the rescue where I've already gotten a level. I'm level 2 now. I have not used any perk points, and I didn't even use the base 7 stats. You get 7 stat points at the start of character creation. I didn't even use them. I left it all on 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play through the game, and I'm going to see where it stalls. I'm going to see where the build that I'm running, which is no build, starts to become too weak to handle the content, and I need to branch into something to actually have an easier time. So yes, I mean, it is a first-person shooter, so there's a point where if you're decent enough, you could still tackle a strong enemy by taking cover and landing your shots and, kiting them, for example. But I'm just going to keep my gear upgraded with whatever I find off bodies. I'm not even going to use crafting. Like, I'm not going to use mechanic and have lots of materials to upgrade my gear. If I can afford to upgrade on breaking down gear that I find normally, I'm going to do it. But for the most part, I'm not going to farm at all. I'm only going to do side gigs and the main story. So that prevents the farm mechanism. Like, some people say, well, you can get strong from just farming. Well, the game scales with your level, so leveling up from doing content is not an issue. It's not going to be the reason why I should be able to handle everything at base stats without any perks. But yeah, so basically, if the game scales with my level, that shouldn't matter even if I did farm. But on the farming aspect, it would matter if I farmed enough to have lots of materials and to upgrade my gear, because there is some upgrading. Like, you do have access to some basic upgrades by default. Yeah, I can already do this even at level 2. So in order to not to abuse that's the reason I'm not farming on purpose. I'm only going to farm, well, I'm only going to do the main content and the side content that's relevant to stories and has actual, proper dialogue in it, rather than just doing the random groups by the side of the road. Unless I maybe come across them and they're like on a way to a quest and I'm like getting out of the car to do the quest and then there's some enemies outside, I'll do that, but I'm not going to go hunting for blue grinding content. So yeah, I just want to share that information so that you know what I'm doing, and this might be a series. I'll see how far I can get in one playthrough. And basically, yeah, I'm just going to play through the game and you can take a look for yourself, see how much depth the character building process matters. Like see how much all of this stuff matters in terms of actually tackling the content. Because yeah, I like the idea that we have many different choices, but if we're OP by default, if we're powerful enough to use brawling and to use melee weapons without any upgrades and still tackle content all the way through to the end game, it kind of defeats the purpose of even having these trees. It's kind of like, oh yeah, I'm getting stronger, but I don't need to get stronger. So yeah, that's what I want to answer that question is, will it scale that badly, or will I be able to take on all the Kabuki fights, all the beat on the brat fights at level 3 body? Like stuff like that, you know, if I can just handle everything, if I can stealth at higher levels and enemies don't detect me with level 3 cool, it makes the fact that, you know, reduced speed at which enemies detect you in stealth, if that doesn't become really fast as I level up, then it kind of defeats the purpose of even leveling cool, unless you want cold blood. And like cold blood is something that you can access, like you don't have that ability by default, obviously, but do you even need it? You know, like, is the game balanced that you actually could need this stuff? So yeah. See how we go. So just to quickly show you, this is my character. I've just picked up base gear. I crafted using my base crafting from dismantling junk that I picked up on the first mission. I crafted a Nova because it's my favorite type of pistol. But yeah, and that's it. So you can check my stats. There's nothing fancy going on here. The base crit damage is 100, and you can see my armor is pretty weak because I'm not getting armor from technical ability, which increases your armor by 5% per level. I think the game needs a lot more balance. It needs like balance in regards to tech weapon charging, penetration. They need to lock all that stuff behind walls, like behind perk walls, because you can get a tech weapon and literally one of the first abilities you get with hacking is ping. You can ping at level 2 and you can shoot through walls at like as soon as you get a tech weapon that has charge. So yeah, it's pretty disappointing when you realize how shallow the character scaling is.
Oh, me.
Build
Any
scaling.
sleep? Time you got up.
Think I might have caught something when I jagged into that corpo's bioline. No, Neurov iris, sir. Need to see Vic. Let him tell me what's got my head reeling, my stomach churning.
Okay, let me take you. I brought you a ride. Throw in some threads, meet me downstairs.
Hey, yo, V. How about
hey,
a round or two?
Regina Jones here.
What do you say?
If you're looking for work in Watson, give me a call.
How'd you find me? How'd you
How you
even
like
know my
my new
name?
punching
I
bag?
Know where to gather my intel.
Just gave me a
You could even call
next-gen
me a
ass
collector.
whooping. He did.
Later, V.
Curious, see how he handles the likes of me. So how about it?
How's it going? Let's do this.
Light on your feet. Keep that head moving.
You got one hell of a punch there, champ.
I ever thought of monetizing it? I can arrange a fight or two. What do you say?
You mentioned. Sounds.
It's like. Fight.
Crystal.
Good.
At all foods.
Feet! Your sweet little 45's waiting for its daddy!
Oh, and I forgot to mention, I'll be doing this all on very hard. Like, obviously not on easy, that would defeat the purpose. So I'm testing not only the difficulty scaling, but how the game scaling works as you progress without using any perks.
Let's have a look. Thanks a lot.
local news. The Aratama Matsuri Festival is nearly upon us. To mark the event, the streets of Night City will come alive with exquisite multi-story dashi floats. The festival program will also include musical performances by biwa virtuosos and theatrical performances in the no tradition. The sponsor for the festival is the Arasaka Corporation. And, in an exciting development, even Hanako Arasaka has announced her participation in the dashi.
So...
just showing you, very hard. Name is yourself. This is before we find anything, obviously.
Man of the hour.
So what's the gig? All right.
I'm glad you're
here. Thanks, Jack. Much appreciated.
Some top-notch work Miguel did. Rides like it looks.
Factory new.
We'll see about that.
Are we rolling or what?
Let's feel this factory new. Orbital
air.
First stop, Ripper Dock, and Holmes. Easy on the gas, huh? I just ate. I was supposed to stop by Vic's any.
Gotta pick up ping because you get that like straight away. Why is it going here? I just like to... why is it white? Oh, select properly. Sorry guys. Maybe I'll try that. Just for fun.
Trace some Klep meds. Someone's stashing them in a Kabuki apartment. Unfortunately, no idea what's waiting for you there, so be careful. Anyway, bring them back, some Rippers will thank you. Profusely. More deets in the attachment.
Bed change.
Oh, okay. So the game just lets you win. Oh, that's interesting. Full potential unlocked at body 6. Like, I've always pumped points into bodies, so I didn't think that this even mattered, but yeah. I don't know what that means by full potential, though. Full charge, maybe? That's interesting. So we've discovered something. I'm sure a lot of people playing on very hard also do pump points into body because it gives you HP.
Stop!
Sure, sure. And you be careful with that trick.
How did you find me?
GPS transmitter. The one you forgot to disable on the stolen meds. Just hand them over, and I'm gone.
Stolen? The Bale of Baradol doesn't work! So who's stealing from who? Who? Ripper Docs! They're the real criminals.
Baloparidol. For cyberpsychosis.
I'm not fucking crazy!
Easy, easy.
Shut up! Go away!
If they're no use to you, they don't work. Just hand them over.
You're the same as them! Rippers, politicians! The same as that fucking Halt!
I could think of a few differences.
Shut up! That bastard he stole from... from research! He doesn't care about the sick! But soon, I'll find him. End him.
The death of one politician won't change anything.
It will! These silver-tongued devils won't dare turn on their people ever again! A line. I'm drawing a line. They can't treat us this way anymore! They can't use us anymore!
It's campaign season. The first ribbon cutter to push an anti-psycho policy after Holt's death is winning that election.
No. No, that's not true. The people will understand. The system will start to fall.
Everyone like you. They'll hunt you all down. Cyber-psycho terrorist on one side, media-backed politicians on the other. Now, who's the crowd favorite?
Leave. Go, please.
No, I can't without those meds.
Over there. I want to be alone.
Thank you.
something you.
Thanks, V. Couldn't have been easy, but you handled it like a pro. Job done, contract closed.
T-Buck sent me. Said you'd have something for me.
Your V. She had... It should...
Okay.
You could tech... You might...
Now, I was actually just going to do moderate content to match my character level, but I'll do a little bit of, you know, harder content here and there just to see if the scaling is badly affected by not putting points in stuff.
But somebody would have taken this gig anyway, right?
Tablet for this man.
I don't know. Maybe there's an angle you can play here. Either way,
and they call
nomads
thieves. Fine. Fine. You got the deal.
These shrimp fresh.
They just arrived.
Aquafarm.
Where do you think? From Pacifica? That...
Ever seen this woman?
I sell food, and I just want to keep selling food. That is all I will say.
Those your threads, or did you borrow them?
Who the hell's asking?
I'm a backer.
Well, well. Two nomads crossing paths in Night City. How can I help?
Looking for this lady. Know her?
The badge? Sure do. She's got a room in this here motel. Right over there.
Perfect. Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Hey, break 100 for me?
What am I? fucking step! Who put out the hit? Give me a name!
Anna, drop this investigation. It's in your best interest.
That a threat? I'd remind you, you're the one in the fucking crosshairs.
Hey, easy. I just want to help.
Help? Phonic implant must be fried. I think you men intimidate.
Just to end your investigation. Really pissed off the wrong people.
Which people? Tell me what fucking people!
Your buddies at the NCPD set you up.
Fucking. I fucking knew it! Robert Kowalski and Bill Adams! Motherfuckers!
Let it go. It's not worth it.
Yeah. Know what? I'm not letting scumbags get me killed! Fuck them! Fuck this job! Fuck this city!
Thanks. All's well that ends well.
Gimme a break. Don't act like you're different from the fuckers who sent you here. You got what you wanted, now fuck off! Got nothing to say to you, Chum.
I'm ready.
You ready? V of the Silver Tongue, eh? Glad we got it all worked out. Contract closed. Gonna send you some malware, on purpose. A demon by Bad, the runner you're gonna help out. You gotta hack a mega building subnet. Spike it with the files I sent you. More deets attached.
Брат, ты лучше туда не подключайся. Поймают, так даже разговаривать не стану.
Upgrade here.
Тигриные когти.
Of recommended daily vitamins.
Thank you.
Keep in mind they aren't hard, so their damage is higher than normal. That's pretty standard for even. My level's not coming into play yet. So that's without any perks. I can already get a tech sniper.
Literature has announced its latest recipient, Virginia Granchester, citing her most recent book, In the Shade of an Apple Tree, as a treasure of this generation. Granchester, who is an AI created by Raven Microcybernetics, has been lauded for several of her works over the years. Her first novel...
That's happy, which means I'm happy, which means you get your Eddies and everyone's happy. Contract closed. Thanks, V. rat problem on my block. Who doesn't, right? Thing is, these rats are human-sized. Look just like tiger claws, too. The biggest one is a certain Taki Kenmochi. So do your fixer a solid and neutralize her ass, will ya? Deets attached.
Shot him dead.
No way. You sure?
I am number six side. Told me everything.
I? I don't see anything. Come on.
I'm serious.
Get him out.
Leave me alone.
It is. This is facing the wrong way.
What it's all about. One less tiger in this town. Appreciate your problem-solving skills, V. Get closed.
Yeah? There's something you want?
So just to double check, it's on very hard. You can see the timer. I kind of edited this, just it's all one recording.
I know where I'm gonna start.
And we'll see how hard these twins are. With no body stack.
No, I'd say that.
You're for a fight. Which one of you's my guy?
Me.
So, fine.
Fair. So?
Show me what you got.
Thank you.
Wasn't that hard?
And you? Had enough like your brother? Or hungry for more?
That ain't my brother! Oh, that's me! Jesus, what's so hard to understand? Here, your winnings.
Good haul.
Don't worry. There's always the next fight. Stop talking to yourself!
Hey, sure the Ripper didn't swap anything else out? Felt like I was fighting against four left hands.
Fuck you!
Listen, out of curiosity, you guys can read each other's thoughts.
No, no. Same person.
Same person,
same thoughts. If that weren't the case, I'd be on schizoid meds.
Incredible. Oh, it's good to see you transition from circus ring to boxing ring.
Give me a break.
Someone who's been extorting regular hard-working folks. Our public enemy's name is Blake, and he is one slippery motherfucker. More info on him and his MO attached.
Jesus, the fuck was that? Let's see what's crawling around here. Skull bashing time!
Finally, I got taken down. And that was more bad luck than anything else. So my stealth is level 3. Yes, it doesn't matter.
There is a problem, you got rid of it. I'm happy, the client's even happier. Good work, Pete. Get closed.
What's the word around Kabuki?
Ho-ho! Ah, there. Turns out... they...
looking to get shit.
Glad they...
Jotaro Shobo. Ring a bell? Guy's a fucking psychopath. Records himself torturing joy toys and sells that shit to like-minded scumbags. Mox finally tracked him down. This is your chance to give this fucker what he deserves and earn a little scratch while you're at it. More on this sicko attached.
ここから去れ。
or if they find the body here, that's so lame. Oh, really? Where? Where?
Bye. enough warning. The Crystal Palace. Feel alive in the dead of space.
Thank you.
happened? Pit! God! Fuck!
So my body's 3, and that's a hard. Is it high danger?
Thank you.
Yeah, so that's like super OP. So I'm using that A. Just gonna avoid using it because it's. Yeah.
One less shithead in this city. Cream. Thanks, V. Closing the gig. Got a Soviet fixer in town. My client wants to show some hospitality, get to know our unexpected guest. Go to the port in Kabuki, pop a GPS on our comrade's ride. Car came with him all the way from the USSR. More info attached.
Investigate.
Industrial zones rich in raw resources, now highly valued in today's economy.
I think I saw something. I'm on my way to investigate.
Silent and effective, just like in the movies. Except we don't make that sort of scratch, but can't have everything, right? Gig closed.
Thank you.
Hey, V, got a friend in need. Wants to snatch back an eye he lost playing cards. An implant, I mean. Should be some easy breezy eds. You in? Catch the deets attached.
What about roulette?
Yeah.
Ever try that?
What do you got?
Well, mommy didn't teach you to read. It's all on menu.
How though? Chance is always the same, isn't it? Either you win or you lose.
None too shabby casino you got. Rotten shame you use it to rob people blind.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, sorry. I mean those files in your comp. The ones I could easily send to your regulars. That is, unless you and I can get along.
What do you want?
Jacob Lamb's eye. Quicker the better.
Tell him he's not welcome here, and neither are you.
I'm a princess, and you're not.
Thank you.
Yeah, so far, roughly the same, but something level 4. See what happens further in the story.
Jacob got his eye back, so I'm closing this gig, but V, we both know that wasn't top quality work. Maybe try a little harder next time, okay? Gig closed, and thanks.
Do a good deed and make some eddies while you're at it. Gotta get someone out of the tiger claw's grip before they chop him into teeny tiny little pieces. You in? Deed's attached. Don't make me ask twice.
Alrighty, so far not a single perk point has been used or a tribute point. And it seems I can carry myself just by keeping my gear, picking up gear, and base level crafting. So I'm not actually using any specific build for this crafting, it's just default so far. So we'll see what happens later into the game. I'm going to end this one for now and continue later. Obviously I can't play all the way to level 30 in one go. But yeah, it's definitely interesting. It's actually enjoyable, even though I haven't accessed like a higher end cyberware. I think I can still unlock most of the skills. The main limitations of not putting points into stuff is you can't use all the access points like opening all the doors or hacking all the nodes, but as you can see, my money has been perfectly fine even without advanced data mine or network interface to find access points. So like normally you'd grab those if you were trying to make money fast and you know, you'd go into this to get your components, but so far, like, if I want to craft a bunch of bed docks, I've got more than enough at the base level. So it's almost like all these perks are just, like, superficial in terms of how strong you are without them. Like, you're already strong enough to take on all the content at least up to level 4. I mean, this is still early levels, so we'll see what happens at like level 30, but judging by how the game scales with your level, it's like I've even been doing the harder content, so we'll see what happens. So thanks for watching, guys, and please like and sub if you're enjoying this, and we'll see in the next video. Bye. And you can also see 304 is the timestamp that I'll be loading, so you can see that I'm not going to be playing this off recording. It's all going to be recorded all the way to the end of the game.